Good evening and welcome to Arizona Horizon. I'm Ted Simon. Starting today, Valley Metro is hosting a series of meetings to get public input on proposals to raise the fares for bus and light rail service. Here with more is Susan Tierney, Communications Manager for Valley Metro. Good to see you here. Thanks for joining us.
Thank you, Ted.
All right, so basically it's come tell us what you think, huh?
We would love to get impact from our passengers, the public, anyone who utilizes public transportation here in the Valley. We'd love for them to step forward and join us and give us some input on a potential fare change or fare increase.
Let's talk about the potential changes here as far as, you know, the single ride fare, the express. Talk about what are we looking at?
Okay, we're looking at a 25-cent increase to the one ride, so that's the simplest calculation that I can give you for the one ride. So that would be for local bus, our link service, and light rail.
What is link service?
Link is a bus service that connects you directly to light rail stations.
Okay.
It currently operates in Chandler, Gilbert, and Mesa.
Okay.
And then we also have a 50-cent increase to express and rapid. Both of those are commuter services. So that is, of course, the different options that you have for each service are available to our passengers as far as fare payment goes, or fare media.
Why 25% increase on one, 50-cent increase on the other?
Well, we did a fare equity analysis earlier this year, and what we found out is that local and link and light rail rider is actually paying more towards the cost of the operations of their trip. So to make it equitable, we have a 50-cent increase on the express and rapid rider.
And so, again, better share the operating costs. In
yes.
When would the increases take effect?
Well, first of all, this has to go through the public comment period, and that closes November 3rd. And then once we do that, we collect all of that information, we can take it to our Valley Metro Board of Directors, and they make a decision in December. And then they will recommend an increase or a change, and then that would be take effect March 1st, 2013.
So it's not going to creep up, not going to sneak up on anybody. I mean, it's a long process.
It is a process. Of course, we have to go in and change our fare boxes and change all the fare vending machines and update all of our collateral material. But we definitely want, now is the time for people to weigh in and give us their opinions.
The idea of I know that there's a 3-day pass right now, and there's talk or serious plans, I guess, might even be in effect, I'm not sure, of a 15-day pass. Talk about those two ideas and where they would be with this.
Well, the 3-day pass isn't utilized as much as we thought it would be, so it really isn't practical for us to keep that available to our passengers. And we did think with this fare change, it might be more practical for maybe the low-income passengers if they only had to purchase a pass that was 15 days at a time instead of the money to spend for a 31-day pass. So it just makes it more affordable.
The 15-day pass, is it still the same? If I were to, in other words, if I spent 25 cents or 50 cents more every day regarding local or express, if I get the 15, do I get a break of some kind?
15-day pass is more economical for the passenger.
It is.
Yes.
Okay. So you want to hear input. You're having all sorts of ways to, mm-hmm. to hear that input. Talk to us about the options, because you don't have to go to public hearings or open houses, do you?
No, you don't. Although we love to see people in person so that they can talk to us and ask us their questions. We do have a webinar that's coming up, and that's tomorrow, actually. So 10 o'clock in the morning. So you can register at our site online at valleymetro.org. And you call in, and then you utilize the website to look at the PowerPoint presentation. And then it does have an interactive session at the end so that you can post questions online, and we'll respond to those questions.
Okay, so webinar, basically, you get to sit at home and get the whole presentation brought right to you.
Yes, yes. It makes it very convenient for people.
And again, Tuesday morning, 10 a.m.?
Yes.
Okay. Social media conversation as well. What's that all about?
Well, we decided for the first time to try tweet chat. So pound VM fares will take you to the place where it gives you more information about kind of our conversation. So we're just wanting people to utilize Twitter to get more information about the increase and to ask questions, and we'll respond.
And that information's on your website for people that...
It is. It's happening October 29th. So it is on our website as well as all of the open houses.
In-person surveys, what's that? How are those being run?
Right, we did that earlier in October. We went to our busiest transit sites where there's a lot of passengers, you know, coming and going from light rail and bus, and we touched them like just by talking to them, by working with them individually and asking them questions. Those questions are available online as well on an online survey. So we wanted to be able to work with them and get their feedback by actually going to the places where they are.
Sure. Now, we kind of glossed over them, but there will be open houses and public hearings as well, correct?
Right. So we have open houses coming up starting tonight through November 1st, and those are cities across the valley, such as Glendale and Tempe and Phoenix, Mesa, Chandler. So once again, those are available, scheduled on our website and available, you know, for you to get the exact address.
How many public hearings? More open houses than public hearings? Or
we're going to have, let's see, I think we're going to have about 9 or 10 open houses, and then we will have one public hearing.
All right. And again, talk about the board who makes a decision here, because a lot of folks, you know, they're going to be they're not too happy about this rate increase, and they're going to say, but who really decides? How does that?
Right, and the Valley Metro Board of Directors represents the community. So the Valley Metro Board is made up of our 16 members, which are 15 cities and towns where Valley Metro provides service, plus the county. And so they are always looking out for their constituents. And this is something that's very, very important to them. They are going to want that feedback from the public.
All right. Very good. Great information. I guess go to the website and get all this repeated and maybe take your time looking over all this information. But good stuff. Good to have you here. Thanks for joining us.
Thanks, Ted.